Hello, it's Helder here. And today I want to talk to you about this tactical backpack that I picked up from a company called Sargent. I had been familiar with Sargent. I reviewed one of their e-tools a little over a year ago and was actually impressed with the tool. So when I saw that they had a backpack with pretty good specs, I wanted to go ahead and give it a review. My main reason is within my Warrior Zero project, I have members asking me about which type of pack they should pick up. So they could go on outings with us as well as their own training, so on and so forth. Problem is, a lot of the packs that I do carry for me personally are higher end, big ticket items, expensive, so on and so forth. So when it came time to trying to find something that was durable, applicable, and at the same time cost effective, I've had a lot of trouble over the last year. And I've tested out a bunch of packs that never even made it to my website because they weren't good to go. So now with this one, I was able to put it through the test, and I want to go ahead and share my findings with you. What impresses me about this pack is its specs. It has a lot of the features that the more expensive, big boys have at a budget price. Things like it comes with 1050D ballistic nylon is what it's made out of, the YKK self-correcting zippers, which is also excellent. You have your buckles, UTX buckles that are located very well built, not just there for show, like many of the other ones that I had found. It has excellent Molly webbing here to be able to give you flexibility to attach whatever you want. Obviously, you could put your patches on here, set up for whatever you would want to put. Also, name tags. You have your Velcro set up there. And of course, you go ahead and mount things on the outside as well as on the inside. I was able to bring it out in the field, test it out. One of the things that I do for not only safety for my dog, but also to be able to allow me to operate with both hands, I like to attach a well-built carabiner or D-ring to my pack and attach the leash to the actual D-ring. Now that right there pretty much tells me the build quality of the pack, because when my 75-pound pit bull decides to pull to the left or pull to the right, on a standard backpack, this would just completely tear off. But during my review process, I was out with him for about 5 miles or so, and he was kind of pulling all over the place, smelling stuff, and I was kind of letting him do that just to be able to get the data that I needed, so to speak, for this review. And it was definitely good to go. I was impressed, and that right there certainly gives it a thumbs up from me. Issues that I tend to find on packs is, even though they might look good and have some pretty good specs, the sewing themselves, especially on the straps, starts to give way, and you can kind of tell right from the beginning if it is sewn correctly or not. And with this one of the first things I did during the unboxing was take this out, give it a few pulls, look around for anything that's starting to give, which once again is a clue, and couldn't find any. The straps themselves, I do prefer a more of a stiffer strap, but to be honest with you, these are extremely comfortable. And it does come with a sternum strap as well as a waist strap. So once again, if you are bearing a lot of weight, it's pretty good to have those fasteners to be able to secure it to yourself, so you could streamline more and pretty much make it more part of your body. So as you're going through trails or doing whatever, performing whatever type of movements, the pack will have the tendency to stay on you and become a part of you. And that is a huge factor when it comes to deciding whether I would give a pack, whether it's tactical or not, a thumbs up. Now you could tell here that I do have my hydration hose coming through, and there is a band to secure it, which is great, so no extra equipment needed. There is a pass through here so that your hose can go right through, and then you could go ahead and secure it. Has a pack, a pocket here that is padded that I keep my solar charger in with the battery. And once again, you can put your tablet in here. If you have smaller laptops, you can go ahead and put your laptop in there. So it does give you some flexibility. And you could also, and right now internally, I have my Camelback bladder inside. You can also put it in that pocket if it's more convenient, comfortable. Once again, the configuration options for this backpack are vast. So that's what's kind of cool. You're not limited. You can set it up to accommodate your needs, as opposed to having to adapt your needs to whatever the backpack provides, which is kind of counterproductive. Inside you have all sorts of padded pockets, mesh pockets, all the stuff that I look for in the higher end pockets to be able to compartmentalize, know where your stuff is, especially in the dark and things of that nature. Internal webbing, which is great, so that you could kind of just hang things to it. Like I have a spork here and a knife and a small Leatherman. So all sorts of options, easy to get to pockets. There is a padded pocket here that you could put your device, sunglasses, once again, whatever your needs are. And also another compartmentalized pocket here in the front for easy to get to stuff. I got my EpiPen in here, unfortunately, that I need to carry with me. And there's all sorts of other pockets in here for pens and markers. And once again, whatever your needs would be. Two external pouches. One, I end up keeping a small shovel in here. And on the right, I have some extra water that I actually do use for my dog to make things a lot easier on the side of the trail. Pull over, get a little R&R, get some hydration inside of him and as well as inside of me, and makes things relatively easy. Now, there are a lot more specs that I can go over with this pack, but what I'll do is I'll put it in my blog post. So make sure that you check that out. For those of you that want much more information, I will have it available on that rather than making this even more of a drawn out review. So bottom line, if you are in the market for a pack that gets very close to military specs and doesn't even come in at a third, sometimes even a quarter of the price of the other ones, definitely take a look at this backpack by Sargent. I'm definitely impressed with it. I am recommending it to my Warrior Zero members. And once again, take a close look. It might be perfect for your needs. Once again, this is Helder. I hope that you found this review helpful.